Dames en heren, in de winkelwarenshow een gast uit Amerika. En een echte oude rocker. Jazeker, we hebben hem gevonden. In de jaren 70 was er een formatie die heette Ram Jam. En die hadden natuurlijk een waanzinnige plaat, Black Betty. En die zanger, ik zie je denken, hoe oud zou die man dan wel niet zijn? Nou, we gaan het zo dadelijk horen. Gaan we bijhalen. Het is namelijk Mike Scavone. Mike, welkom in de show.
Hey, good to be here. How you doing?
I'm doing fine. You're the man of Ram Jam.
Yeah, I guess I am.
So many people ask me something about that song. They want to know the story behind the records. Can you tell me the story, Black Betty?
Oh, that's a long story.
I have time enough. Let's go.
Okay, good. Well, we're going to use up that time then.
Okay, man.
Story really goes back to, as far as Ram Jam itself doing it, that was all Bill Bartlett, our guitar player, who was also the guitar player for the Lemon Pipers. They had that song Green Tambourine back in the 60s. He was the one that discovered the Lead Belly version of that song. Now, Lead Belly and Lead Belly's estate has the publishing rights on that song and the writer's royalties on that song. But I found out from somebody over there in Netherlands, in fact, that Lead Belly did not write the song, but the song was originally recorded probably a year or two prior to Lead Belly copywriting this song, going back now to 1933, 1934. That's how long ago that song was first recorded, and it was done by a guy named James Ironhead Baker, which Alan Lomax had recorded in prison. Mm-hmm. So you had Ironhead Baker singing, "Whoa, Black Betty," and all the inmates behind him singing, "Bam-a-lam." And that's how the song went. And even Lead Belly's version is just Lead Belly by himself clapping his hands. And his version was more of, "Oh, Black Betty, bam-a-lam, whoa, Black Betty, bam-a-lam, Black Betty had a baby, bam-a-lam, damn thing went crazy." And then Bill Bartlett got a hold of the song and put all those guitar riffs and drum solos and everything else behind that and wrote a couple more verses to it, in fact. Because the song, Lead Belly's version, was really the middle section of a three-song medley and had really just one verse and one chorus. So Bill Bartlett is really the one that should get all the credit for that song, but he gets nothing for writer's royalties, unfortunately. And, you know, we picked up that song in 1975, 76, and recorded it with Kazanets and Katz in Long Island, and put it out then.
Okay.
On Epic Records.
But that song was totally different.
Well, Bill Bartlett, like I said, is the one who really rearranged that whole thing. You know, I was a drummer in a band called Sauce at the time, working in Kazanets and Katz's studio. And they were looking for, basically for a frontman and a singer for Ram Jam. And the guy that was actually the lead singer in Sauce, they had approached him and said, "Look, we're looking for somebody. Would you like to do this?" Because we were doing studio work. We were there for about 2.5, 3 years just playing tracks for songwriters that Kazanets and Katz had sung. And when he mentioned it to him, he said, "Nah, you know, you should talk to Mike because he's much more of a rock and roll singer than I am." And so they asked me to try, and I did, and everything is history after that.